Welcome back to EduHunt program in biology. Today we are going to discuss about one of the first year topic, that is fluid connective tissue. This fluid connective tissue nothing but blood. So we have different connective tissues. From those connective tissues, only one tissue is fluid in nature, that is fluid connective tissue is blood. And the blood, to study about the blood, is hematology. See here, blood travels through the blood vessels by the contraction and a relaxation of the heart. So this is the process is known as cardiovascular system. So blood leaves from the heart and enters into distant or different parts of the body through the blood vessels. This is cardiovascular system. And the percentage of the volume of the RBC occupied, in this total volume of the blood, how much amount of the percentage occupied by the RBC, this is known as hematocrit value. See, in this blood, we are going to discuss about two components. One of the component, it is plasma. The formed elements, and the second one is blood cells. Plasma and the blood cells, these are the components of the blood. From those blood, here the plasma is constitute about 55% the total volume of the blood, whereas the blood cells are, it is constitute about 45% of the total volume of the blood. Now we are going to discuss about the plasma and the blood cells. Here first one, we are going to discuss about the plasma. In this blood, we collect the plasma before clotting of the blood. See, a small experiment is there to identification of the plasma and the blood cells. Take a small test tube. In this test tube, here add some amount of the blood here. After adding some amount of the blood inside the test tube, add sodium oxalate, and sodium citrate solutions. So these are the solutions. By adding of these sodium oxalate and sodium citrate solution, after some time we observe, above this one is, we observe a pale yellow colored structure, before clotting of the blood. This pale yellow colored structure is known as plasma. So we collect the plasma before clotting of the blood. And now the reddish colored structure which is present here, this is known as blood corpuscles, mainly RBC. Okay, na? So in this plasma, now In this plasma, around 92% of the plasma it is occupied by water. Occupied by water. 92% of the plasma it is occupied by the water. And the remaining 8% of the plasma that constitute about here salts and plasma proteins, albumins, globulins, salts and plasma proteins and hormones, enzymes, digestive nutrients, excretory products, all these are present in this plasma. Not only this one is in this plasma that contains several electrolytes like sodium, potassium, calcium and magnesium of bicarbonates and chlorides, sulfates, sodium chloride, sodium bicarbonate, sodium sulfate. These are the components, electrolytes are also present. See here, sodium bicarbonate, sodium chloride, sodium sulfate. And potassium bicarbonate, potassium chloride, potassium sulfate. Calcium bicarbonate, calcium chloride, calcium sulfate. Magnesium bicarbonate, magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate. These are also present in the plasma. Not only this one, now we are going to discuss about the plasma proteins. The plasma proteins are fibrinogen and prothrombin. So fibrinogen and prothrombin are the plasma proteins are helps to clotting of the blood when there is an injury or the wounds. These are the plasma proteins are present. See, and coming to the globulins are abundant serum proteins. It is an abundant serum proteins. It is divided into alpha globulins, beta globulins and gamma globulins. Alpha, beta and gamma globulins. From those three globulins, the gamma globulins are known as antibodies. These are also known as immunoglobulins. Antibodies are the gamma globulins are also known as immunoglobulins. These immunoglobulins are identification with a word that is IG. Immunoglobulins. Those are five types. These immunoglobulins are IgA, IgD, IgE, IgG and IgM type. These are the five types of immunoglobulins. The immunoglobulins are five types. Those are IgA, IgD, IgE, IgG and IgM type. These are five types of immunoglobulins. So now coming to that, the remaining one is albumins. the albumins of the serum proteins, these albumins, it is derived from liver and lymph vessels. That albumins are the parts are derived from the liver and lymph vessels. This albumins maintains the colloidal osmotic pressure of blood. The colloidal osmotic pressure, it is maintained by the albumins only. It is derivatives of the liver and lymph vessels. Salts are, these are all salts, and plasma proteins, those are fibrinogen, prothrombin, albumins, globulins, several hormones, enzymes, nutrients, and excretory products also present in the plasma, in this plasma. So these are the introduction of that is regarding to the plasma. Now we are going to discuss about the blood cells. The blood cells of the blood. Here I forgot one point. In this plasma, the plasma of the blood that maintains the acid base buffer and maintains the blood at pH is at 7.4. The blood pH is 7.4 because of the plasma. This plasma maintains the acid base buffer that maintains the pH at 7.4. In this fluid connective tissue, the blood cells are red blood corpuscles, and the second one is white blood corpuscles, blood platelets. These are the three blood cells in the blood. So the red blood corpuscles, white blood corpuscles, and blood platelets, these are the three types of blood cells. Red blood cells, it is RBC, also known as erythrocytes. Whereas white blood corpuscles, another name is leukocytes. White blood cells, another name is leukocytes. Whereas blood platelets, another name is thrombocytes. Another name is thrombocytes. These are the three types of blood vessels, whatever it may be. The formation of the blood. Formation of blood is known as hemopoiesis. The formation of the blood cells are known as hemopoiesis. In these hemopoiesis, here the blood cells or the blood cells are originated during embryonic stage. It is originated from yolk sac mesoderm. So the formation of the red blood cells is hemopoiesis during embryonic stage. Those are originated from the yolk sac mesoderm. Later the red blood cells are originated from the liver and spleen. It is the largest lymphoid organ. The largest lymphoid organ is a spleen. See, later in adults, these red blood cells are originated from red bone marrow. So later these red blood cells are originated in adults from the red bone marrow. This is the introduction about the blood cells. Red blood cells, red blood corpuscles, erythrocytes, white blood corpuscles, leukocytes, blood platelets, thrombocytes. And the formation of the blood is known as, is called hemopoiesis. During embryonic stage, it is originated from the yolk sac mesoderm. Later, it is originated from the liver and spleen. Now, the blood, it is originated from the red bone marrow.